Okay, the probably the one thing that's sticking with you is that we are going to add the two equations together, right? Okay. Now what's going to happen if we add these two equations together? What are we going to get? Kids?
X.
You're gonna like what? When I add it together, what's the result of adding it together?
Well, right now you'll get negative 4y and 9x equals 2.
It's minus 4y equals 2. How do I know that wasn't really a good thing? It's not exactly what I wanted, agree?
There's no elimination.
Right, something should get eliminated when we add the equations together. That's the whole idea behind adding equations together. Okay? So what do we do about it? Sean?
Multiply the equations by -1.
So these two are so close to eliminating each other, they just need to be opposite each other. They will be opposite if we were to, say, take this equation and multiply it by -1. So that would give us the first equation again, 3x minus 2y equals 4, exactly the way it started. Then we would get -6x plus 2y equals, make sure to multiply the other side by -1, we have positive 2. Okay. Now when we add them together, we'll know that it was a good thing because the y's are going to eliminate each other. 3x minus 6x is negative 3x. 4 plus 2 is 6. Divide by negative 3 and x is negative 2. Good? That makes sense? Any questions so far? Okay. Because we're not quite done yet. One last thing to do. What are we going to do now?
Find y.
Find y? How, Kenneth?
By substituting x in.
By substituting in negative 2 for x in either of these equations. To the top. All right. So my choice is 3 times negative 2. 2y equals 4. 6 minus 2y equals 4. Add 6 to both sides. Divide by negative 2. Now we have x and y. Any questions? Fusion? Anything at all? Alright, feeling good? Number 16 then. I like these two examples that we picked because with this one, all we had to do is switch the sign of one of these. But with this one, it's not as easy as that. We have to do something a little bit more. We still want to get a couple of these to be opposite each other. We got to be a little more creative. So either I want to get the x's to be opposite, or get the y's to be opposite. And that way we can get them to eliminate. Josie?
Well, you can multiply the top one by negative 2 to get a positive 2y.
I like that. Right. So multiply this by negative 2. The top equation being multiplied by negative 2, we'll get negative 4x plus 2y equals 0. Because anything times 0 is 0. Bottom equation stays the same, 3x minus 2y equals negative 3. Okay. So far so good, any mistakes? Mistake there. Okay. And we'll put a line there, we'll add them together. Negative 4x plus 3x is negative 1x, so negative x. 2y minus 2y is nothing. So negative x equals negative 3, so x equals positive 3. So x equals 3, we'll use this equation here, we'll plug in 3 for x. Minus 2y, 3 times 2y equals negative 3, 9 minus 2y equals negative 3, subtract 9 from both sides, divide by negative 2. Agree? Okay? You ready to show off your skills? And your homework review? Sounds like it. All the rest of the cooking. Let's clear our desks and get ready for that. one, it's like optimal setup for us, ideal. What do we do? Johnny?
Add the two
x's.
Yeah.
X's, the y's together, the numbers together. It's 3x, no y's left. 10 minus 19 is negative 9. Y by 3. X is negative 3. Now we know x. We use x to find y. So 2 times negative 3 plus 4y equals 10. That's negative 6. We'll add 6 to both sides. 4y equals 16. And y equals 4. So our solution is what?
Negative 3, 4.
Negative 3, 4. Just always remember that when you're done. You're going to give your final answer of the pair of numbers that works for x and y. All right. Now for this one, it's not quite optimal. You gotta do a little something, help it along, right? Anybody besides Johnny got an idea? Monica.
Multiply the bottom equation by positive 2.
Alright, multiply by positive 2. I like that idea. So the first equation, I'll just rewrite 4x plus 5y equals 14. By positive 2 gives us a negative 4x plus 6y equals 8. Trouble doubling 8 for a second. I'm going to add these both together. The 4x minus 4x is 0x. 5y plus 6y is 11y. 14 plus 8 is 22. Divide by 11, and y is 2. The other y is 2, so we'll plug that in. I like this equation just because x is positive. So 4x plus 5 times 2 equals 14. That's a 10, so we'll subtract 10. 4x equals 4. X equals 1. So 1, 2. For x and 2 for y. All right. Good. Do you have any questions? If you like pros on the elimination front? Yeah? That's pretty nice, isn't it? It's not too hard to learn, and I think it makes solving systems pretty darn easy. What do you think?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pretty cool. Sometimes substitution is easier, you know. When might substitution be easier than elimination? Johnny?
If like y equals something that x equals.
Yeah, if it just like your system already says y equals 2x plus 3. It's just ready to go, plug it in. Right. Sometimes that's a little easier, especially if your other equation says like x plus y equals 4. You know, like x plus y, just plug it right in. It is faster. It's faster to do that than it would be to switch everything around, so the x's and y's are on one side, make sure that they're opposite each other in some way. It's going to save a few seconds. Okay. So today, solving systems of equations again, but something funny is going to happen. So let's solve this system. I'm sure you guys can handle it. So everybody solve this system, but then, you know, notice what happens when you do. Okay, so what are we going to do first to get these to work together? Great.
I just did the bottom one times negative 1.
Okay, so you like took this whole thing, multiplied by negative 1, and we wind up with 3x plus 2y equals 10, and negative 3x minus 2y equals negative 2, right? Mm-hmm. But then what happened?
Both
of the x's, the x's and the y's both cancel. We got nothing on this side, and on the other side, on the right side, we got 8. So, well, we have to figure out what that means, because we did everything right. It must mean something. We have to figure out what it means, huh?
Does it mean that can be any real number?
That's a good guess. Maybe it can be any real number, if they both got canceled out. What else might it mean? Yeah?
There's no solution.
There is no solution. Okay, so you got two possibilities, I think. Definitely, you know, not one definitive solution, for sure. There's not one answer. If there were, it would have just worked out the way all the rest of the other thousands of these that we've done have worked out, right? So it works out differently. To help you see what's going on here, we're going to go back to our first approach to solving systems, which is graphing. Okay. in order to make these easier to graph, I'm going to write them in slope-intercept form. Okay? So I think we're all familiar, comfortable with slope-intercept form. So for this green one, I'll work in green here. And I'm going to put in slope-intercept form y equals mx plus b. Right? So I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. I get 2y equals negative 3x plus 10. Then what'll I do?
Divide by itself.
Right? Y by itself, divide by 2. So we get negative 3 halves x plus 5. Alright, so got a y intercept of 5, slope of negative 3 halves, right? No problem. You can graph that easily. Then I'll work this other one out to paint that in black. We'll subtract 3x from both sides, we get 2y equals negative 3x plus 2. Divide by 2 on both sides, you get y equals negative 3 halves x plus 1. So what do you notice about these two?
They're parallel.
Good. You notice that? You know that that's true because of what?
They have the same slope.
They have the same slope. Okay. Remember back when we would graph two lines and we would find the solution that way? What were we looking for? What? The intersection. That told us what the solution was. What intersections are these going to have?
None.
None. They're parallel, right? That's the definition of parallel lines. They never cross. So we can just tell, without even having a graph, we can tell that they're never going to cross, and so there must be
no solution.
Okay, so we said maybe it's all real numbers, maybe it's no solution. Turns out to be no solution. Let's just plot a set of axes here and go ahead and graph it and see that we're right. All right, so we've got the green guy here is the y-intercept of 5. Got a slope down 3 and over 2. Right here. Yeah, let's grab this here. Okay. 2 down. 3 over 2, down 3 over 2. 1. Okay, and here. Okay, so there's the green one and the black one. It's got a y-intercept of 1, it's got a slope also of negative 3 over 2, and it's parallel, as we've already stated. We'll grab a non-tool, draw it in black, and see that these two lines, which represent those two equations, are never going to cross, therefore the two systems will never have a solution in common. There's no solution to this system, no solution. What do you think, we could tell a little bit more easily with the equations written in slope-intercept form, getting ready to graph them if there was no solution. What about from our work in trying to use elimination? How could this tell us that there'd be no solution? Yeah?
Well, it's saying that, like, when you go through all the work and you don't get, like, an answer for it, mm-hmm. it's showing that there is no points in which they cross. So then there
can't be
a solution.
Okay.
It's parallel, since they don't have any points
mm-hmm.
that they cross on.
Okay. Well, let's look at another system. Let's solve this system the same way and see what happens there. Okay. With this one, you're going to have to multiply both equations by something different in order to get them to cancel out with each other. So the results from this will be just slightly different. A little bit weird, still a little weird, but different from the last one we did. All right, let's say I'm looking at the system, I'm trying to figure out how can I get something to cancel out. Let's say I'm gonna try and get, I'm gonna try and get the x's to cancel out. What would I have to multiply this by and this by to get the x's to cancel out? Alex?
You would have to multiply the top one by negative 1, and then you have to multiply the bottom also by negative 1.
That's going to give us a 9x and a negative 6x. When I add those together, they're not going to cancel out. Charlie?
Multiply the bottom one by 1.5.
That could work. They're all even. So you multiply this by 1.5, and that will give it to 9. Did anybody, let's just maybe just multiply by whole numbers. I mean, that will definitely work and shouldn't change a thing.
negative 5, top one by 2, and then bottom one by 3.
2, 3. Okay? I think that's just, on average, it's most successful for most people to multiply by whole numbers. And so what happens, we get negative 18x plus 12y equals 36. And here, the equation in black is going to become 18x minus 12y equals negative 36. So when we add them together, everything on the left side cancels out again. We get 0 on the left side. But on the right side, we get
0.
Also 0. How's that different from the result we got here? We get 0 on the left side on both. Oh, you mean they're both 0?
Yeah.
Yes, they're both 0. What would you say the difference is between, like, if both sides of this equation are 0, how is that different from one side of the equation being 0 and the other being 8?
Yeah. It's true.
It's true. 0 does not equal 8. But here, 0 is equal to 0. Okay, so here's, this is true, which means this would be false. In one case, we get a true statement, in the other, we get a false statement. So probably something different going on here. Cadence?
I think that maybe they're the same line.
Maybe if we graph them, they'd be the same line, and that's why we're getting a true statement.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see, like, these two equations are almost identical. And in fact, if I were to multiply this by a negative 1, they would be exactly identical. Multiply this by negative 1, you get negative 18x, just like that. Positive 12y, just like that. Positive 36, just like that. They are. They're exactly the same equation. And the exact same equations are going to make the exact same graphs. Okay? And so if we were to graph these, what would happen? I graph the first line, and I go and graph the second line. What happens, Johnny?
It'd be the same line.
Yeah, you just graph the same line, right on top of the line you just drew. Sean?
What if the 18 has a negative and the 12 bottom one, but the top one stays the same. Would that still be the same equation?
Let me see if I understand what you're saying. What if the this one?
Yeah, wasn't negative.
If it was negative?
Yeah. Would it still be the same equation or not?
So it would look like this. Top equation looks like this, you're saying.
Yeah.
Exactly the same as it is.
Yeah.
This one's negative. But the 12 is also still negative.
Yeah, and the rest is the same.
Then, no, they're not the same equation.
Okay.
And they're very, we've gotten similar numbers. But, like, if I were to add these together, try to use elimination, the y's would cancel out, and the x's,
okay.
And I would have just an equation, or a system of equations that does have a solution.
Okay.
And if I quickly, in red, rewrite this in slope-intercept form, add an 18x to both sides, dividing by 12, I get, or maybe this one would be easier, numbers are smaller. I get y equals 3 halves x plus 3. And the black one, where we subtract 6x from both sides, divide by negative 4, and what we wind up getting is y equals 3 halves x plus 3. Well, we already said, right, that they are the same equation, that they have the same y-intercept, they have the same slope. If I graph one and graph the second one, they would just be right on top of each other. So where would they intersect?
Everywhere.
Everywhere that's on the line, right? Not everywhere, like all over the plane, but everywhere that one line is, there the other line is. They intersect at all points on the line. So we would say that there are infinite solutions. There are infinite solutions. But we wouldn't say all real numbers, because it's a little confusing. Because keep in mind, a solution to a system is two numbers that come together as a pair, right, and work together, and they both solve the two equations. Right? So all we can really say is that I can't just randomly plug in an x and a y. One x goes with a specific other y, so they have to come in pairs and work together. But I could choose any x, figure out what y goes with that x, and that same x and y would work in this other equation as well. And any pair that works in this equation will work in this equation and vice versa. Okay? So we say infinite solutions. We could say all points on the line, that line right there, or you can point to that one right there, because they're exactly the same. But if you were to just say infinite solutions, that would be perfectly acceptable. I see that they're the same line, and they would just have all the same solutions. And we can tell, we can rewrite them in slope-intercept form, we can graph them and see that they're the same line, or we can look at the result of elimination. Okay, somebody's going to make a statement here about the results of elimination and how to tell what result we have, what solutions we have. Okay. So if all the variables cancel out, and what means what? If this happens, then I know this many solutions exist.
Well, if you're getting to like the subtraction part, or you're subtracting the top equation from the bottom equation, if the 10 or the -2, if those things are the same but one's negative and one's positive, then you can have zero equals zero.
Uh-huh.
As long as the other side also
so if everything on this side is the same, they cancel each other out. This side is the same, they cancel each other. We got 0 equals 0.
Mm-hmm.
How many solutions do we have?
Infinite
solution. So to generalize that, if somehow we come out with 0 equals 0 or 1 equals 1, that's not going to happen unless you do something funny. But as long as the equation that results and has no variables in it is true, if it's true, we have infinite solutions. And if it is false, we have how many solutions?
Zero
solutions. Good.